going on, everyone? It's Marcellus back with another video. Today, we're just going to be doing a short little update for Baby Doge, going over something that you should not miss inside of Baby Doge. This is a big opportunity. And also, we're going to go over the technicals very briefly. It's going to be a short little video, so definitely hit that like button and subscribe. Remember, I'm not a financial advisor. None of this financial advice. Leave a comment in the comment section. And also, if you want to go ahead and follow my Instagram, go ahead and do that. Link will be inside of the description. I'm going to do some updates on there and also going to let people know when I go live on there as well. So let's get straight to it. First things first, we're going to talk about the opportunity you do not want to miss. So this is thankful for 1.6 million holders. Yes, we're now, well, we've been past 1.6 million holders, but we're getting close to 1.7 million. But now that we have 1.6 million holders here, you're going to see that we're going to be getting 1.6 trillion baby doge to one lucky person. So you do not want to miss this opportunity. All you have to do is retweet the post, tag three people, and follow Baby Doge official Twitter. As you see, I've done it right here. And everybody else is doing it as well. So if you don't want to miss out on this, definitely do it, because this right here is very true. You could be about to hit a gold mine right now. So that's what you want to do. You want to be right there. Anyways, definitely don't miss this. This is going to be pretty big. One lucky person is going to get it. And anyways, let's talk about some other stuff in Baby Doge. As you can see, 14.74 thousand US dollars has now been burned inside Baby Doge in the last 24 hours, which comes out to be about 13.14 trillion baby doge. Also, as you can see, our holders are increasing every single day here in Baby Doge. We're getting so much closer here to getting into 1.7 million and eventually 2 million. But yeah, we're up 3% for the last 24 hours. That's definitely all good. Now for the technicals. You can see Baby Doge did break out of this little pattern here that we've been forming. I mentioned that yesterday. And you can see it is starting to go back a little bit up on the upside here. So there is always the possibility for us to go on the upside and hit the 1250 resistance, especially with the 5th of October being the mainnet release date for Baby Doge. So on the 5th of October, we should be having the mainnet being released on that day. And that will definitely trigger a lot of buying in Baby Doge leading up to there. So, hey, it's always a possibility that we don't get, you know, that we don't just have this huge drop all the way down to where I was talking about earlier at the 1.0 area. So there's always the possibility that we don't go all the way down here. So let's just talk about what would happen if we were to become bullish for the October 5th release of the mainnet. So this is pretty much what will happen once the Baby Doge swap comes out and leading up to the Baby Doge swap. First, you'll probably end up seeing is Baby Doge, you know, getting stopped here. Obviously, this is our support, our resistance right here for the Fibonacci retracement. So this is our resistance right here at 1250. So that would be the first area that we would get stopped at with Baby Doge. And honestly, the next area here would be pretty hard for us to get to, but it's still a possibility, you know, inside this bear market and all. But, you know, 1350. And, you know, it kind of is still the same thing as it's always been. We still have the same resistance lines. We still have every single 40 point here or 50 point over here for Baby Doge. So 1550 and then eventually around like 1650 up here. And then, yeah, they're always at these 50 marks. So 1750, we're going to have those resistance, you know, for the next, I don't know how long for Baby Doge. It just depends if the mainnet, people are pumping it, and then we have a nice pump going up to the mainnet. That's pretty much all that it depends on. Now, looking over here at the 4-hour chart, it's kind of the same thing. If we were to become bullish, then you would also see the same type of movements here for Baby Doge. So, like I said, it would stop here around 1350, and then over all the way up here around 1650, and then eventually all the way up here around like 1850, and then, you know, eventually on and on up until we hit the actual Fibonacci retracement all the way up here for Baby Doge, which is around 2200, more so about 2250, right? Anyways, that's all we got for the Baby Doge technicals. Now Bitcoin. As you can see with Bitcoin here, you know, we hit this little green area here, and now the green areas are supply and demand, more demand. That's why you're starting to see more demand flowing into Bitcoin. And my prediction for Bitcoin the other day was right down here. So I predict that Bitcoin will still get down to 18.2K regardless of the increase in price that we're seeing in Bitcoin. Regardless of that, I still believe we will get down to 18.2K. Now, will Bitcoin become bullish temporarily? Maybe. You might actually see it breaking past this resistance here of 19.3K and eventually getting up to about 19.8K. But I still believe that Bitcoin is going to ultimately go down further. So inside of the near term, as in a month from now, 2 months from now, 3 months from now, 4 months from now, 5 months from now, possibly even a year from now, all this could come into fruition and going down to about 18.2K. But I still believe the ultimate bottom for Bitcoin is still going to bring us all the way down to about 14K. And I'm sticking with that prediction. I still believe that's where we're going and heading here with Bitcoin. I still believe it's going to continue to pull back until we get all the way down to 11K. Well, 10K to 14K. Those are my two areas for Bitcoin. So I still believe that ultimately we're going to pull down to there, trade sideways for a little bit longer when we're down there, and then have a pump. So yeah, 2023 is going to be crazy. I definitely think 2023 will probably be the year where we do hit that the 11 or 14K area. So we might not even hit 14K to 11K this year, or we might have it. You know, we might hit it this year. We might hit it by the end of the year. But either way, 10K, 14K, we're definitely going to have to hit that area. And then eventually we're going to have a pump coming out from there. But yeah, like I said, none of this is financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor at all. Definitely go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe. Leave a comment in the comment section if you like the video. And also let me know what you all want me to go over next in the comments. And also, if you want to go ahead and follow my Instagram, go ahead and do that. Link will be in the description. I'll update you all on when I'm going to be making my videos on my stories on there. And also when we're going to be having the live streams on there. Because I noticed a lot of people miss the live streams because I usually do them impromptu. So I'm going to try to let people know when those live streams are going to be coming up next. So yeah, definitely do all of that. And remember, I'm not a financial advisor. None of this financial advice. As always, I'll be back with another video.